Well, the next thing that we're going to look at is the when. When was it written? And you might say, Jack, why is that even important as to when? It's a very important question, and it's a very important thing to find out, because the when question as to when it was written allows us to have, number one, credibility in our study, meaning this. When we find out and when we learn from our background or introductory information, getting into the book, when we find out the when, now you can correlate that with what else is going on in the known world at that time. That will help you understand cultural influences. It will help you understand, for example, this was going on in the Middle East at that time, and at the same time, we understand that these things were taking place far into the Western European influence, or possibly even into the Orient itself, or even into Asia, things like that. It's just fun. And you say, well, why does that matter? Because when you're, for example, sharing with somebody or witnessing, maybe you are even going to teach a Bible study, when you can say that, for example, I happen to be, again, 1 Peter. 1 Peter here, it's dated 63 AD. When you're teaching or studying for your own self-edification, you might wonder, what's going on in 63 AD? What's happening in the rest of the world? And you can determine, wow, this was happening there. This was happening over there. This is happening here in the Roman Empire with Peter, 63 AD. You can also then find out from secular history, which is a blast, right? To look and see from secular sources what was going on in the Roman Empire, that it's not that it's not in the Bible. Certainly some stuff's not in the Bible. Wasn't relevant. It's not important. But you will find out that there's other things regarding what's happening in the empire or in the church or with uprisings of cult thinking or those that would be, for example, attacking the deity of Christ. Where did that come from? How old is that view? The Gnostics, Platonism, things like that. Who are these people? What are their sources? So when it comes to the when question, it gets to be fun. Now, let's be honest. Most of the dates are great to know for background learning. After you know that, it's just not going to be so much of a factor for the general or the recreational Bible student, I'll put it that way, where it really gets exciting and very controversial. Is in the book of Revelation. Book of Revelation, when it comes to the when, is remarkable. It's split right down the middle, for example. There are those who are known as preterists. And the preterists view the authorship of the book of Revelation much earlier than what someone like myself would be. There's the preterist, which believe that the book of Revelation is complete. That's a general statement. Versus a futurist. I do not believe that the book of Revelation is complete. I believe that the book of Revelation was given when? In real time to John on Patmos, as it says, but then Revelation gives you an outline in the first opening chapters. There's the addressing of the seven letters to the seven churches, which are clearly seven geographical churches at that time. And yet it's a representation of churches when? Throughout the last 2,000 years in every generation of the church to this moment. But as a futurist, I believe that the book of Revelation was written around 95. A lot of scholars, a lot of profound scholars teach that. You say, who cares? When it comes to the book of Revelation, the when is extremely important because it has a lot to do with prophetic declarations of the Bible. It has a lot to do with where the church is at any given time, the last 2,000 years and now. When we look at the book of Revelation, the dating of it is extremely important. And so I believe that the book of Revelation, by virtue of the fact of not only ancient publications of those who were almost there, but the fact that it fits to the entire narrative of the book of Revelation. Here's a great thing to keep in mind regarding not only as you approach the Bible in all areas, but the when question. When you look at this and you get the data and the information and the background regarding the timing of it all, when it was written, it helps you to understand that God is the God of the Bible who from ancient times speaks into the now, but also predicts the future. He is awesome. And the God of the Bible is the only God that can do that. All other gods are man-made and fake. So when the when question is brought up, it's vital to dig it up. It's your decision. It's your choice as to how deep you'll go on that. And again, most cases, it's fun to know. It's great to know. As I said earlier regarding the book of Revelation, it's critical. So the question is, when was it written? So when you embark upon your study of a particular book of the Bible, you're going to want to dig down and to find out the when. And again, you can find that in an excellent study Bible. You can find that in a good commentary. And you can find that, of course, safely in the right places online as well.